I'm going to count us down. Here we go.
Head's counting us down.
3, 2, 1.
Wake up, tune in, feel the buzz. It's time to begin. Keith and Ed, they're here to spin a show that's off the leash, beyond the norm. Off the cuff.
Welcome to another Off the Cuff. I'm Keith Murphy. This is Ed Wilson, and we had our longest gap of off the cuffs.
You've been off the rails. I mean, going crazy. This has been such a period of time for you where you, of course, with following the Iowa women. And by the way, great job. I know you don't even want to hear it, but you did a great job. The baby that you had at that was in Albany, I think.
Albany, that was Kate Martin's nephew.
Right. Just great. Yeah, just a great moment. You should go look that up on our website. I think it's still there. But excellent job, front to back.
It was quite a trip. I did not expect the Iowa women to go all the way back to the Final Four this year and to the championship game, to do it in back-to-back years. It was something to see, and I don't think I'll ever see anything like the media circus that follows Caitlin Clark and the Hawkeyes around. It's not just Caitlin Clark, but it's mostly her. She has reached this level of celebrity that goes beyond just being an outstanding student, athlete, of being an outstanding sports star. Once in a while, somebody will cross over into that celebrity where, especially in Albany and Cleveland, they were all these TikTokers and influencers were showing up, to do stories.
Of course
they
were, right, yeah.
Yeah, and it's just...
You know what? Caitlin Clark's going to make my numbers pop. It's going to be what it is, right?
And she does. Like, she moves the needle in her sport and even beyond her sport in a way, but not on a large scale as like Tiger Woods did with golf and Michael Jordan did with basketball. I mean, just brought so many more people in to the sport. And her final three games each broke the record for most watched women's basketball game ever, broke the one before it. And then that number on Sunday, 18. 4 million more than the men's championship game.
Right. I know. I did see that at the side-by-side. And there's been a lot of side-by-sides.
Yeah.
Saturday Night Live did their lead-off skit last Saturday. This might date this piece here, but it was the NBA guys all talking about, or the college of NCAA guys talking about, who are these guys? Oh, what about Caitlin Clark? It was great.
I saw that because they are NBA guys. They're usually covering the NBA.
Right, yeah.
And so they asked Barkley a question about like the men's tournament. He's like, I don't know. I'm not watching that. I'm watching Caitlin Clark.
Keenan does such a great Barkley, too. It's awesome.
I don't have time to watch that. And, there's some apples and oranges involved in that. The women played Sunday afternoon on ABC, and the men were on three different networks. You combine the rating of those, but it still comes up 4 million short. And it's been that way for a few years. And the women's game has not passed the men's game until now. But we've seen, the effect of all that. It's created more fans, more interest in the sport, in women's basketball. And it's not all going to stay at the same level. Some of it is the Caitlin Clark phenomenon.
Sure.
But some of these fans will stick around and keep watching. And you're seeing what the WNBA, the Indiana Fever, who are going to draft Caitlin Clark, they announced today that 36 of their 40 games are going to be on national television.
Right. I heard that. And not only that, but I saw the ticket prices so far. If you wanted to get tickets now, they're like $70 for the cheapest tickets. Those are going to go through the roof, I would imagine, you know, just because of the Caitlin effect. That is a hefty load for her to carry. And there are so many positives, but also kind of the negative stuff that I've heard lately about, the jealousy maybe.
And there is some of that.
A little animosity, things like that, hey, don't look over my folks here. We have other great players here. Don't forget about us. We've been here before. We were here.
Yeah, and I think that also shows women's sports are like men's sports, because we've seen that, especially when it comes to salaries, it's really tough if you played the 1970s and you were a big star in your sport and you made $100,000 compared to these guys now that are getting like $200-300 million deals.
Yeah.
There's some real resentment out there because they're like, hey, we set this up. We created the interest in the sport. Where's our money?
That kind of thing is kind of life, isn't it?
Yeah, it
I mean,
it is.
It's just living that period of time that you were just born into. So, but I get that.
There's some real jealousy out there, though. Oh. There's some real resentment toward Caitlin, but she has handled it really well. She gets on the podium. She has done nothing but thank the fans and her teammates and the people who came before her. She's done a really good job at the podium and addressing all of that. She's been like the adult in the room. Sometimes when the adults are acting like children, I think she's done.
I think back to
well
Mr. Ed's 22-year-old self. Yeah, oh, there's yeah. no way I would be that together.
She's 22. She just turned 22. And I think she's handled the jealousy and some of the resentment really well, too, because there's not really anything she can do about it.
No.
And she is a fiery competitor on the court, and sometimes her emotions get the best of her. But there are many women who are fiery competitors like that. So I think in time, Ed, I think what's going to happen is the women in the WNBA and her teammates, if Caitlin ends up being put on the Olympic team for Paris this summer, right. I think she will be. I think she'll be the only college player on there or former
college player. Are there 14
player.
And there's only 12 that they take?
Only, they take 12. 14 tried out, but she couldn't try out because she was in the Final
Four. That's right, she was in the Final
but
Four.
But they can put on whoever they want on the team, and I think they will name her to the team and she'll go to Paris. But she's going to win those women over with her talent and also...
And her work. It's not just, you know... God didn't just put like a perfect situation into her body, but she worked on it. You know, she made it hard, and she works her took us off.
She,
to get that
she
done.
Works her butt off. Funny how that works. And also, I think the other women, when they take a step back and they think about it, they're going to realize like, oh, she's going to help all of us make more money. She's going to help all of us be recognized more in the WNBA and in the Olympics. Now, is it going to last long term? That's what we don't know.
Right.
But you can already tell. I mean, you can walk into our newsroom and see there are a bunch of people that are going to watch the WNBA for a while here. Now, can they capitalize on it? We'll see.
And what is the WNBA package? Is it like $35 or something?
$35 for every game.
For every game. Yeah, you can another subscription that I will forget about and not cancel later. But here's a great litmus test. My wife loves to watch Caitlin Clark when she's playing. She couldn't give a rip about basketball. We were watching the championship, and she said, how come that little clock down at the bottom is ticking when they go away and they get the ball? I said, that's the clock. They have to get rid of the ball or make it, blah, blah, blah. So, but it's fun to watch that. It's really fun to see that people get involved.
There have been so many, and so many people have reached out to me, and unfortunately, many of them have to report back disappointing news, but they're like, I've heard from a lot of people, like written a letter to Caitlin and her teammates and would like me to deliver it to them.
Yeah.
Or is there any way you could get an autograph for this fundraiser we have coming up? And those days are gone with Caitlin Clark. Yeah. I mean, the requests, I was talking to Bailey Turner, who coincidentally is from our area. He went to Boone, and he's sports information for women's basketball. Really great young man. And boy, what a ride he's been on for a couple of years. And he said, whatever we think the requests are, it's way more than that. It's like hundreds a week of requests of something from Caitlin and lesser extent her teammates. Because it's not just her. They got pretty famous, too.
Well, and not just the Caitlin effect, but also, there's a lot of people around her now that weren't around her before. I think when like last year, you could get closer to Caitlin. Now, this year, she has her own bodyguards. She has her own people around her. She's escorted to and from, which she needed.
Final Four, they kept her at her own podium, even when she was off the big podium, because some of it was safety concern, because there were so many cameras. They thought somebody's going to hit her in the jugular with their camera.
Right.
You've seen that semicircle around her
exactly.
That was in Albany. So by the time they got to Cleveland, they're like, we've got to keep her safe. And it was so surreal. Like at one point, I'm walking down a hallway and I look over and I'm like, that's Robin Roberts, Darius Rucker, and Jason Sudeikis in a little triangle talking women's basketball.
I heard you talk about this on radio. It was so.
What?
What?
Like, how? There's kind of a random.
They would never be together if it wasn't for this. Maybe.
I
don't know. Maybe they're all good friends. I don't know.
It was something. And I thought after the game, too. Caitlin and Lisa Bluter seemed of the primary people, they seemed the least visibly upset.
Yeah.
I think they knew with that South Carolina juggernaut that everything would have to go perfectly. And for a quarter it did. Like Caitlin scored 18 points in the first quarter, teammates
more than
were playing
anybody
well.
Else in her first quarter, but
But they have seven McDonald's All-Americans on that team. They have a 6'7" center.
I was going to say, they also have somebody that's almost 7 feet tall.
Yeah. They have five players taller than Hannah Stolke, Iowa's tallest player. So you knew if it didn't all go perfectly, and I think they knew that going into it. So it was a little different than last year when Iowa was favored, and Caitlin and Monica Sonato got in foul trouble, and you could feel kind of the frustration of, oh, that opportunity may never get back to the championship game again. Well, it got back the next year, which is incredible. And Lisa said, I'm not apologizing for finishing second out of 350.
And I loved Coach Bluder's talk to the women at the end, saying, hey, hold your head up high. We made it this far. This is something that you have to take with you and celebrate this, you know.
Who wouldn't want to play for her?
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
As you know, my wife Jenny graduated from Iowa State, but she texted me during the lineups the other day. I mean, Jenny's an Iowa State alum, and she's like, I don't even get it, but like introducing these women, it's making me cry. Right. I've got tears in my eyes. I've gotten too attached to them. I'm like, I'm a mess here watching the lineups. I got tears. I get it. That's the impact sports can have. And I know that team didn't bring everybody together. They're a rival of Iowa State.
Sure.
And there were some Cyclone fans that just were like, I'm not rooting for our rivals. And I get that. And most people are respectful.
As long as it's done in a civil way. You know,
some
have some civility.
Civil, most were. Most were.
Be your team's biggest cheerleader. But don't step on somebody else's cape when they're being a superstar.
I don't think we're going to see anything quite like that again.
No.
So that was fun. And it's good to be back.
I'm so glad you're back.
I'm glad to see you, too.
I hugged this guy when he walked through the door.
It's true. He did.
Missed him so much.
Thanks for watching Off the Cuff.
No script, no plan, just go with the flow where the topics land. Well, nobody knows. It's a laughter, it's stories we adore with Keith and Ed. You'll always want more. So bring your thoughts and bring your cheer. We're breaking molds with every gear. In the show, we're family setting the pace. Off the cuff, where the vibes are right. Lining up your night. Every moment's a surprise. Wait and see. Off the cuff, where vibes are right. Keith and Ed lining up your night. Every moment's a surprise. Wait and see.